Good morning, cadets. Today I'll be starting a new chapter, lesson number 2, Kari the Elephant. Before we proceed to the chapter, let us know some facts about the elephants. Elephants live in Africa, Nepal, India, and Southeast Asia. Elephants live in the desert and in rain forests. What is an elephant's diet? Elephants eat grass, leaves, bamboo, bark, and roots. They also like bananas and sugarcane. Adult elephants eat about 300 to 400 pounds of food each day. Elephants' behavior. They live in tight matriarchal family groups of related females. Herds consist of 8 to 100 elephants. Males leave the herd at 12 to 15 and live solitary lives or with small group of other males. Physical appearance. Largest land mammal on earth. Massive body and large ears. Long trunks, which they use for many reasons, like a straw or a horse to drink or help to take bath. Trumpet to communicate, like a hand. This is an African elephant. An Asian elephant. We can see the habitat of elephants. Animals are very important to the nature. So, save the elephants. The story of bringing up Kari takes us through the life of the narrator, who has a baby elephant. The name of the elephant is Kari. The boy grows together with Kari and through this story narrates his experience. The story is a very sweet narrative that makes us grow fond of Kari. The relationship the narrator shares with Kari is very pure and sweet. Both are small and they enjoy the company of each other. Kari loves taking bath in the river and narrator takes him for morning baths to the river. The friendship of Kari and the boy is endearing. One day, Kari even saves the life of a boy who was drowning. He does some mistakes. He mischievously steals bananas, learns lessons of his wrongdoing. So he's a very sweet animal. And the lesson also shows us how he learns many tricks and how the narrator trains Kari. So it's a very interesting chapter where you come to know how the bond between a human being and animal is very special. They love human beings so much and they are ready to do anything for the human beings or their master. So we should always try to treat the animals with lot of love, care, sympathy. Never try to shoot them with a gun. We should always shoot them with a camera. Lesson 2, bringing up Kari. Kari, a 5-month-old elephant, lives and grows up with his 9-year-old friend and keeper. So Kari is a baby elephant and he lives with a 9-year-old friend and keeper. Kari does not eat much. Just about 16 kilograms of delicious twigs a day. Kari is very playful and sensitive, and the lesson tells about how Kari saves a boy from drowning. So Kari is playful, sensitive, but very intelligent also. Kari, the elephant, was 5 months old when he was given to me to take care of. So a boy is narrating the story. He is 9 years old. And when Kari was 5 months old, he was given to the narrator. I was 9 years old and could reach his back if I stood on tiptoe. He seemed to remain that high for nearly 2 years. So this boy was shorter. We grew together. That is probably why I never found out just how tall he was. And where did Kari live? He lived in a pavilion under a thatched roof which rested on the thick tree stumps so that it could not fall in when Kari bumped against the poles as he moved about. So he had a special place for living. One of the first things Kari did was to save the life of a boy. Kari did not eat much. He nevertheless needed 40 ponds of twigs a day to chew and play with. So, Curry was fond of twigs. Every day, the narrator would take him to the river in the morning for his bath. And Curry loved to bath. He lied down on the sandbag and the narrator would rub with that sand on his back for an hour. So this baby elephant was fond of mathing. After that, he would lie in water for a long time. On coming out of his water, his skin would shine because he had a good bath. And it would shine like ebony. And then he would make a squealing sound. Squealing or trumpeting is the cry of a elephant. So in the picture we can see the place where Curry lived, and you can see the narrator also. He is a short boy. With pleasure, I rubbed water down his back. Then I would take him by the ear because that is the easiest way to lead an elephant, and leave him on the edge of the jungle while I went into the forest to get some twigs for his dinner. So, Curry, after the bath, he would roam in the jungle and the narrator would collect some twigs, very tasty twigs he wants. One has to have a very sharp hatchet, that is a small axe, to cut down these twigs. It takes half an hour to sharpen the hatchet because if a twig is mutilated, an elephant will not touch it. So elephant also has choice of food. It will not eat anything and everything. It was not an easy job to get twigs and saplings for Curry. I had to climb all kinds of tree to get the most delicate and tender twigs, as he was very fond of young branches of banyan tree. So Curry also had his choice of food. He will not eat anything and everything you give him. He wanted delicate and tender twigs, and poor narrator spent lot of time gathering. I was gathering some one spring March day in March when suddenly heard Curry calling to me in the distance. As he was still very young, the call was more like that of a baby than an elephant. So one day when the narrator was collecting twigs, suddenly Curry started trumpeting, squealing. I thought somebody was hurting. So narrator thought that Curry was being hurt by somebody. So the narrator came down from a tree and ran very fast to the edge of the forest where he had left Curry. But he was not there. To the surprise of the narrator, Curry was not there, though the narrator had heard him trumpeting or squealing. I looked all over, but I could not find him. I went near the edge of the water and I saw a black something struggling above its surface. Then he went near the water and he could not see Curry, but he saw something black was there inside the water. It was struggling. Then it rose higher and it was the trunk of my elephant. I thought he was drowning, and the narrator thought that his baby elephant had fallen into the water. I was helpless because I could not jump into the water and save 400 pounds of him. So the narrator was also 9 years old, and the baby elephant is quite heavy. So he thought that if I jump into the water, I cannot save Kari, since he was much higher than I. But I saw his back rise above the water, and the moment he caught my eye, he began to trumpet. So I told you, trumpet means to cry and struggle up to the shore. And Kari suddenly saw the narrator. He started to trumpet. Then, still trumpeting, he pushed me into the water, and as I fell into the stream, I saw a boy lying flat on the bottom of the river. So Kari saw a boy, another boy. He was lying flat on the bottom of the river, and Kari wanted to save the boy. He had not altogether touched the bottom, but was somewhat afloat. I came to the surface of the water to take my breath, and there Kari was standing, his feet planted in the sandbag and his trunk stretched out like a hand waiting for mine. So Kari was mischievous, but Kari was very intelligent. So what did Kari do? He extended his trunk and said that, "Hold my trunk and save that boy." I dived down again, pulled the body of the drowning boy to the surface, but not being a good swimmer, I could not swim ashore, and the slow current was ready dragging me down. So the narrator was not a good swimmer, so and there was a current inside the water, so it was dragging him. Seeing us drift by in the current, Kari, who was usually slow and ponderous, suddenly darted down like a hawk and came halfway into the water, where I saw him stretch out his trunk again. So Kari was very understanding. He understood the narrator's problem. So he came halfway and then again gave his trunk. I raised up my hand to catch it, and it slipped. So in the picture we can see what's happening actually. I found myself going under the water again, but this time I found that the water was not very deep. So I sank to the bottom of the river and doubled my feet under me, and then suddenly kicked the river bed and so shot upwards like an arrow, in spite of the fact that I was holding the drowning boy with my hand. So both Kari and the narrator are trying to save the boy who was there in the river. As my body rose above the water, I felt a lasso around my neck. So Kari, he put his trunk around the narrator. He understood the narrator is also a young boy of 9, and he has to save another boy. This frightened me. I thought some water animal was going to swallow me. So the narrator suddenly thought that some water animal has come and it will swallow him. but it was Kari's trunk. I heard Kari squealing and I knew it was his trunk about my neck. He pulled us both ashore. So Kari, with his presence of mind, is trying to save the narrator and the boy who has drowned.
Good morning, everyone. My name is P. Ashwita Yadav. Today, I am going to tell about Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao campaign. Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao is a combining campaign of the Government of India, Ministry of Women and Child Development and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare jointly started this scheme. This scheme covers all the states of India and its union territories. The Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao scheme has three primary objectives, which are preventing female infanticide, developing new schemes and working jointly to make sure that every girl child is secured and protected in our country. This scheme has a target to ensure that every girl child gets a quality education too. Beti Padhao Beti Bachao is India's one of the most high profile campaigns. It is essential to look for the benefit of this scheme. This scheme will empower the girl child in our country. Some significant impacts of Beti Padhao Beti Bachao are balancing sex ratios, bringing girl child right into focus, achieving girl child access to education. Thank you, everyone. Good morning, everyone. My name is B. Ashwita Yadav. Today, I am going to tell about Indian Army Day. Indian Army Day is celebrated every year on the 15th of January. It is celebrated since on this day, in the year of 1949, the Commander-in-Chief of Indian Army, Field Marshal M. Kariappa, became the first Indian Commander-in-Chief. The Indian Army was formed in the 18th century under the British government for nearly 200 years. The taking over the post of Chief in the Indian Army in 1947, hence is very significant in Indian history. It signifies the complete uprooting of British from our country. Parades are held in Indian Army Day with the display of military weapons. It is also a way of commemorating the selfless duties of all the soldiers of the Indian Armed Force. The bravest of them are awarded on this day with various medals. We are lucky to have the protection of the Indian Army. Hence, we should acknowledge their hard work and endeavor by celebrating Indian Army Day. Thank you.
Good morning to all respected teachers, seniors and all my dear friends. Today I am Cadet Prasada Richangi from class 7C going to tell one story, that is the Honest Woodcutter. Karim was a poor man. He earned his living by cutting wood and selling it. He had a big family to support. One day when Karim went into the forest to cut wood, he slipped off and his axe fell down into a nearby pond. He tried his best but he could not get it back. He started weeping. Suddenly he heard a voice calling, "Karim, what is your problem?" He lifted his head and saw a fairy in front of him. He told that, "I lost my axe in the pond." The fairy said, "Don't worry, I will get back you your axe." Saying this, the fairy dived into the pond. The fairy came up with a golden axe decorated with precious stones and asked, "Karim, is this your axe?" Karim said, "No, this is not mine." Once again, fairy dived into the pond. This time, the fairy came up with a silver axe. Once again, Karim said, "No, this is not mine." The third time, the fairy came up with a Karim's axe. Karim was filled with joy. The fairy was also happy on Karim's honesty. The fairy gave all the three axes to him and blessed him. In this story, the moral of the story is honesty pays. Thank you. Jai Hind. Good morning to all respected teachers, seniors and all my dear friends. Today I, Cadet Prasada Richangi from class 7C, going to tell one story, that is the Curious Monkey. A carpenter was working hard to divide a log into two parts. He was sawing from morning to noon but was able to cut only halfway through. He was hungry, so he pushed a wedge into the split and went for lunch. The monkey was watching the carpenter. He became curious of the wedge. He climbed down from tree and went up to the log. He tried to pull the wedge. It did not yield. He sat on the log with legs on each side. The tail was dangling down through the split. He tried again and again. All of a sudden, the wedge came out. The log stuck together with a snap, cutting off the dancing tail with it. The monkey loses its tail because of his curiosity. In this story, the moral of the story is, look before you leap. Thank you. Jai Hind.